Like many Chinese Filipinos, George SKT was born into a life of business.
I remember when I was young, my mother, the relatives, would say that your father is doing well. Someday, you have to be in the place of your father. You ought to be successful in business, and you are born to be a businessman.
But nothing came easy for the young man.
I was working with my father's company in a textile import business. Since there's nobody to help him, it ended up to be my job. So the people are saying that, how could a young boy do this kind of work? So they say that my father is not using a horse, but using a dog. The dog cannot do anything.
To be a good son and a good businessman, he had to give up many things, like a college degree.
I went to USD for the beginning of the college. But you know, I stay in USD not too long. I cannot concentrate in schooling. I'm thinking of a lot of things, especially business.
But one dream he held on to was that of opening a bank, despite all the odds. Through sheer persistence and determination, he secured a license from the Central Bank. Metro Bank was opened in 1962 with several partners, when he was only 29.
What do I know about banking? I never worked in a bank. So nobody will help us. So we have a hard time. I say I will put up a bank and to be the biggest one day. I put up Metro Bank.
I first met Mr. T when I came home from my studies abroad, and I was aware that my late father was involved in collaborating with someone. I was struck by the fact that here was someone forming a bank and yet he was so young. Well, at that time, the leaders of the banking industry were veteran businessmen.
You know, at the beginning, very simple. No bank would like to do business with Metro Bank. Una, they think Metro Bank is not safe. With that young boy, how could you trust him?
But Metro Bank moved up quickly, thanks to its founder's industry and vision.
Being the newest bank then, Mr. T's strategy was to concentrate on what is now known as the middle market. Our symbiotic relationship with our small retailers and middle market clients became the strength of Metro Bank, then and now.
I was the one insisting when I founded Metro Bank that we have to go into the Filipino community. We have to get all the Filipino customers if we want to grow big. At the time, there's a difference. The Chinese deal with Chinese, the Filipino deal with Filipino. I say, no, we are in the Philippines, we have to deal with everybody.
He gave equal opportunity to both male and female. To him, it is merit-based.
The organization took care of us, not only me, but most of the senior officers. They gave us the opportunity. They sent us to school, they sent us to training, and it's up to us to really develop ourselves.
In using people my ways, be strict, but be kind. And when you can afford, try to give them more to make them more confident.
But he is not just strict with other people, he is strict with himself because his discipline is unbelievable. I have worked with this bank for the last 14 years. He has been absent 3 times in 14 years. He has been late 0 times.
He's managed the company in a much more modern way. He's been very forward-thinking. He was always a wise man. He's run the bank on a very careful, very conservative basis.
But Dr. George SKT's legacy consists in far more than establishing a successful bank.
He told me in the early days, Chito, I can only eat so much. Whatever extra, therefore, you should share it with others.
We have many excellence program. Our thrust is to look for outstanding teacher, the military, policemen, artists.
I've seen the reaction of people. They say, here's a Metro Bank awardee. It means a lot. It's not just the money. It's never the money. It's the recognition.
The Metro Bank Foundation likewise extended its financial assistance to the youth.
Feeling that there should be some financial assistance to poor but deserving students, he decided to put up a 10 million program annually.
Our family was having a financial difficulty, and I was looking for a means to pursue my education. I was a Metro Bank scholar from 1999 to 2003.
Art also has a special place in the heart of this businessman.
I like paintings. When I look at it, I'm happy.
The award given by Metro Bank to outstanding Filipino artists is among the most sought after.
More than the prize money, the validation that you are an artist is actually the award itself.
Today, Dr. George SKT's legacy of excellence and service continues on in the next generation.
I'm a very strict father. I told my children, you have to start to be able to support yourself first, then to go up. Don't depend on your parents.
You don't live the life of a rich man's son. You have to work for it. And that's one of the ways that he tried to instill that in us. So personally, I started working in the bank at age 10 as a messenger during the summers. And that continued all the way through college, and eventually, when I graduated, I officially joined the bank in 1991.
Yeah, since we were young, we were taught not to be complacent. We have to do more than what is expected. And that's something, until now, actually, we try to pass on to the younger generation.
You must think your dad is a really strict man. But then, you know, that was a conscious decision, because when I decided that I don't want to be a friend to my children, I want to be a parent, then that's the way I want to raise you guys. I don't want you guys to be spoiled, and, you know, look at the outcome.
I'm proud that he has, what he has achieved in terms of his philanthropy, his commitment and contribution to the Philippines and its economy.
It's really the value system that, and the philosophy that I've mentioned before, that he leaves behind. He's very concerned now, not so much about his children, but his grandchildren. So we pass on to them a lot of the things that we learned from him.
A good name of George T. Very good reputation of the name, the family that he has built.
But I always have faith that in banking, for so long as you do it properly, honestly, with a name, you are going to grow it. So as far as I'm concerned, I always stick to that sincerity, honesty to our client. Trust. I'm trustworthy. That, in my opinion, is the most important asset.
Trust, hard work, and faith in the Filipino. These values have sustained Dr. George SKT throughout his life and are a beacon for others to follow.
There are sayings in Chinese, in English, in Western, easy come, easy go, correct? So in my opinion, if you don't go through all those hardships, even the money will not stay with you. Sooner or later, you will waste it. One of the things that I hope or I hate is that the Philippines should come up faster and better. Don't forget, we are close to 100 million people. In the world, we probably will be the top 20 countries in the world. But you look at our GDP, look at our people's life, very far. But I also believe in life. There's a circle. This is the century for Asia. They're bound to go down. Europe, US, enough now. Let us be the one. Dr. George SKT stands for sturdy hope, solid achievement, and unquestioned competence. He succeeds in all his endeavors because he always insists on integrity, excellence, and hard work. Because he prides in his word of honor, Dr. T's attributes and life work are interwoven by one eminent and shining thread: trust, with a capital T, as in his family name, George S.K.T.